Falling on your feet, do you finally see what you're missing?
I sat down to edit this video when I realized that I forgot to record an intro. So yeah, in today's video we are going to play, or I'm going to play, with new products that I've just purchased. I'll let you know how they apply, what do I think about them, and what are my favorites. And with this occasion, I'd like to wish you all a wonderful holiday time, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. I received this eyeshadow palette in the last Trend Mood Box Volume 22 that I hope the video is already up on my channel. And as you can tell, this is a neutral eyeshadow palette and it has both formulas. So it has cream and powder and is targeted to help you do a full face of makeup. Now, I already have my brows on. I'm going to refer to the shades as we go along. So yeah, all the products that I'm using in today's video are going to be listed down below in my description box. Now I'm going to zoom you a little bit and I'm going to start with the eye application. I already primed my eyes, so I will have all the information about primer in the description box. Also the brushes that I'm using in today's video. I'm going to use my new hand mirror that I received from Flower Nose. It is new, so this hand mirror is absolutely gorgeous and I wanted to use it in today's video. I'm going to take the shade called Chiseled to run that into my crease. I'm going to use this shade as my transition, not as a crease shade, with the brush Blender Pro from Sonia G. Next shade I am going to take is the shade Sculpted. I'm working with Cool Tones and this shade I will run it through my crease and slightly in the outer V. So at the first glance, I would say this eyeshadow palette, it is not that pigmented, or the shades, the matte shades are not that pigmented, because I've heard mixed feelings about this palette. But as of now, even the shades are not so pigmented, I'll say that they blend really well. I'm taking this one from BK Beauty, A506. This is the Harvest. Excuse me, this is the problem when I'm using a hand mirror, that I'm covering what I'm doing. Using the same shades on my lower lash line, and I'm not worried if I'm over applying, because later I'm going with the concealer. So I want to keep the smokiness outside of my eye, because this helps to elongate your eye in case you have smaller eyes. I'm going back to blend everything together using the same brush that I use for the transition. And now I'm going to take a flat brush. This is also by BK Beauty. It's A505. And I want to get the shade that I've used in the transition. So the Chiseled. And add that on my lid. Now, I have two options on my mind. First option, it would be to use one of those, or maybe both, Charlotte Tilbury Color Chameleon eye pencils. I have the Champagne Diamond and the Pillow Talk. You can tell how much I've used from Pillow Talk. But I think I'm going to use this for the inner portion of the eye. But for the entire lid, or for the center of the lid, I'm going to go with the Charlotte Tilbury Eyes to Mesmerize in the shade Oyster Pearl. So this is a creamy formula. And for this, you should use a synthetic brush, or you can use also a blend of synthetic brush. My favorite brush to use with this type of product is the Sonia G Builder Fusion brush. So this is from one of her latest collections called Eye Fusion. And there are 5 brushes. You can also use your finger. I think it looks nice. Now I'm going to add the Champagne Diamond on my inner corner, but going also a bit to the upper lid. So I find this method and this liner brightens up my inner portion of the eye. And because I also want to use the Pillow Talk, I'm going to run that on my lower lash line. I'm going to use the Makeup by Mario eyeliner on my waterline. and a little bit going upwards. I don't know, guys, if you hear some noises, I think there is some ongoing activity outside because it just snowed, or it's still snowing, and I believe people are going out to clean out the snow. I have no control how to make it disappear. I'm going to curl my lashes using the Refru eyelash curler, the original one. And when you curl your lashes, especially if your lashes go downwards, I advise you to hold the curler for 15-30 seconds. It really helps preserving the shape of the lashes. A mascara that it's not new to my channel, just I have a new tube, is this one by Sephora, the Big Definition Mascara, one of my favorite mascara. It has just a normal wand, but I love the way it applies, and also it doesn't smudge. It gives me volume, doesn't clump the lashes. It also provides length, not so much, but I like it. The eye makeup is done. So as a first impression, I would say that I love the matte formula that this eyeshadow palette provides, because they blend well. They are not very pigmented, but they are blending well, and also there is not a bit of a fallout. So I think this is a more pro formula. The shades are blending beautifully together. I absolutely love the way my eye makeup came out. In the break that I've been taking, I was working for two other videos, and I have applied the concealer, the Natasha Denona High Glam, and I applied the L'Oreal True Match Nude Plumping Tinted Serum in the shade 23 Light for the rest of the face. Now I want to use one of those shades to contour my face. And for this purpose, I was thinking that the shade Chiseled, the one that I also used for the transition, it's working perfect to carve out my cheeks. Usually, I use my bronzer shade on my crease. For this purpose, I'm going to use the Makeup by Mario double-sided brush. This is the number F4. I'm going to take this small part. I can also use, but I did not pull it out, my BK Beauty 109 brush. It has the same size and also the same shape. So this is the shade I'm going to work with. This is a cream to powder formula. So it's a cool toned. It's a cool toned shade, I wanted to say. I'm going to use the color next to the chisel, and that one is Mirage. I want to have a more warm shade for my forehead. Yeah, it's very subtle. I would say related to the contour part or the cream part, it will be better if your skin is slightly darker or maybe light to medium, because on my skin tone I cannot use the darker shades too much. This is the final result. And for the blush, I'm going to use this one that is new for me, the Makeup by Mario Soft Pop Plumping Blush Veil in the shade Perfect Pink. So I'm going to use the larger side. This shade is perfect. I like more pink shades on my blushes. I also love coral, peachy pink, but I love pink. I think you can also use this for your lips. What a great idea you have, Julia. Actually, this is the second time when I'm wearing this, and it is very long-lasting, so I'm happy with my purchase. Now I'm going to set my T-zone using the Catrice Invisible Matte Powder. This is a brush that I have it from Beautylish. It's by Chiku Hodo, and it's called Simply a Cheek Brush. And for my cheek, I was intending to use this Milani blush in a shade Romantic Rose, but I am thinking if will not fade the shade. Maybe not. Okay, I'm going to use a Refru 04 brush, and I will just set a little bit. Now for the moment that I was wanting, for the moment that I was waiting for the entire day, is to use for the first time the Rare Beauty highlighter, the shade Enlightened. Isn't it gorgeous? Oh god. So I'm going to use the Sonia G mini cheek brush. A little bit, and it is so strong. Sometimes I apply the highlighter and then I go with the blush. I find that it looks a little bit more muted, especially if the highlight is strong. Going with my Gerard Cosmetics lip liner. I have already tested this Flower Beauty, very comfortable formula. Normally I would leave it like this, but I want to also use or try on this Kali Ray Big Swell Hydrating Glassy Lip Plumper that I also got it in the Trend Mood box. Let's see how plumpy it is. It's transparent and this is the applicator. And wait for the plumping effect. As we speak, I'm starting to feel a slight tingling.
A few moments later.
Guys, I don't know if you are able to tell. I will insert a before and after. But right now, I have about maybe 10-15 minutes since I've applied this Kali Ray lip plumper. I went downstairs after I finished recording. I just want to let you know that my lips look like I have been getting a Botox job. So I think the preferable way is to apply this lip gloss before your lipstick. I haven't had this big lips in my whole life. But here you guys, this is the final look using all those new goodies that have entered in my collection. I am excited with everything I've tried in today's video, so I'm looking forward to hear and read your comments about the products that I've tried in today's video, and also what do you think about the look that I created using the Donessa Myrick's Groundwork Defining Neutral Eyeshadow Palette. So I think it's a good palette. It's a little bit chunky in my opinion. It takes a little bit of space in your collection, but it's a very versatile palette and I'm looking forward to get more use out of it. I'm over the moon that I got my hands on the Rare Beauty highlighter, the Enlighten highlighter, and the Makeup by Mario, the new Soft Pop Plumping Blush Veil. It is absolutely gorgeous. And of course, I'm excited for my new bestie, my new brush from Makeup by Mario. I think I'm going to invest in a couple more of his brushes, especially the face ones. And one more thing, if you are interested about the nail polish that I'm wearing in today's video, this is by Essie, it's the Gel Couture formula in the shade Model Clicks. So it is this right here. I have it for 5 days, if you can tell. It's starting slightly to wear off. And the jewelry, those are from Read Your Heart, the V-shaped, and this one. And this is from Ana Luisa. And the necklace and the earrings are from local shops in Romania. But yeah, this is all from today. Now I'm really signing off. Bye, guys!